What's good, y'all? This your boy Black G92. Now for this evening, I'm going to do a reaction to kick things off for my annual 31 days of Halloween. I'm like currently three days late on it. I'm gonna catch up on it with like posting not only this reaction, also two more reactions tomorrow. Maybe push it to three more reactions, so then I can be caught up on it, so that I can make the targeted 31 days, 31 videos. So that's a goal for this year. I plan on sticking with it, so no one can do the same thing about it. And plus, regardless of how tired I get, I'm just gonna push through it. Do a live stream every weekend, like early, even as early in the morning or even during the evening. We'll just post a bunch of content, cause yeah, I got a whole lot to make up for that absence I've had the past few weeks. So yeah, I'll make up for y'all and just double back on some reaction requests. But anyway, enough of the long ass intro. I'm going to do a reaction to this Jeff Goldblum documentary made for the group Gravediggers, and it's titled Gravediggers, the Fathers of Horrorcore. And I'm going to see what this documentary look like in about 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Shit. Damn, I double clicked on it. Man, get this shit off my damn screen. Shut up. Alright, let's get to it. I dig the intro. And I've heard the name Jeff Goldblum on Twitter. I think that's the same guy.
Horrorcore can be traced back to the 80s through groups like the Ghetto Boys and Gangsta Nip.
Facts.
The subgenre didn't officially become coined until 1994 with the Gravediggers album 6 Feet Deep. This is one of the greatest rap albums of all time and came from one of rap's first supergroups. It's easy to look at Prince Paul and RZA in 1994 and think that they were on the top of the game, with Paul coming off a 3-album classic run with De La Soul and RZA on the cusp of one of the greatest producer runs in history. But the Gravediggers weren't created at the top of the mountain. They were assembled from the ashes of 4 careers that were struggling to take off. Prince Paul started assembling the Gravediggers in 1991, when the 4 artists were all at a low point in their careers. RZA was then known as Prince Rakim and was struggling to get his solo career off the ground. Too Poetic was a struggling solo artist on Tommy Boy. And Fruquan, who had left the group Stetsasonic years earlier, was designing and selling clothes out of his house. And Paul was devastated and in a state of depression after his record label Doodoo Man Records fell through and failed. Paul decided to call the 3 MCs he knew, who in his mind were the illest in the world. And since they all had not much going on in their careers at the time, they went right to work together. The group created a demo that they were proud of and shopped it around to all the big labels at the time.
I dig the little intro, background intro, not intro, I dig the little like background instrumental that Jeff Goldblum's using. It like, kind of like, sound like the robber song that Koopsa Nigga made. I dig the whole reference to Koopsa on the little instrumental, whatever. And I had no idea, it sounded like an interesting backstory with how the Gravediggers formed. I had no idea it had such a long history prior to them debuting in 94. I do remember reading an article somewhere. I think it was like more so linked to an article on Wikipedia stating that how the term horrorcore was coined in 94 by this group. I might have to check them out though. Check out their album. Let me know if you want me to do a live stream of their songs off their debut album.
Found by everybody. Jive, Def Jam, Tommy Boy, and many more. After years of getting rejected, Paul was right about to give up. RZA was off doing his own thing with Wu-Tang. Fruquan was in the clothing game. And Too Poetic was homeless and was about to take a job working at a bagel factory in Long Island.
Damn.
But then, just when all hope seemed lost,
down bad,
Paul got a call from G Street Records, who offered them a deal.
Okay. Blessing in disguise.
6 Feet Deep was released in August of 1994 and is one of the greatest rap albums of all time. The name The Gravediggers was meant to be a metaphor, as the group was setting out to resurrect the mentally dead. The term horrorcore was actually coined in these Gravediggers sessions by the legendary hip-hop journalist Havelock Nelson. The image that the group created is what the entire horrorcore genre stands on. With the classic dark production and horror imagery, they even renamed themselves to fully embrace the themes of death that they're going for. Prince Paul was the Undertaker. Fruquan was the Gatekeeper. Too Poetic was the Grim Reaper. And RZA was the Resurrector. None of the 3 MCs of the group knew each other before Paul introduced them. So it's amazing that they had such incredible chemistry.
I know, right?
They all fully embrace the concept of the record, and each MC brings their own style and flair to each song. Fruquan comes through with the more laid-back and cool verses. Too Poetic brings the energy with these melodic Far Side meets ODB off-the-wall flows, and the RZA raps possibly better than he ever has in his whole career. Most of the album was produced by Paul, so it really gave RZA a chance to focus on his MCing. The album is incredible from start to finish, but I would be remiss if I didn't mention what is probably the group's most popular song, 1-800-SUICIDE. The song represents what the group is all about, featuring a dark and sort of spooky beat, with the group tackling a horribly morbid topic with a sort of cartoonish and absurdist twist on it. This would be the perfect intro song for anybody who wants to know what horrorcore is. Shabazz the Disciple and Killer Priest make excellent appearances on the concept track Diary of a Madman,
okay,
which is another standout here. Prince Paul actually has told a great story about the creation of this track. He says that when the four MCs laid their verses, there was no concept, nothing bridging the verses together. So Paul added the courtroom interludes after the fact, helping to create a story that these four rappers were all currently on trial pleading insanity in a courtroom. And that's just what makes Prince Paul so important, especially to this group. His unique creative vision is able to take what would otherwise be just dope beats and rhymes and turn it into a classic. Now, the Gravediggers to Prince Paul was always meant to be a one-time project, so on their follow-up he took a bit of a backseat, only working on a couple of tracks. The Pick the Sickle and the Shovel was released in September 1997, and is extremely underrated. I understand the historic significance of their first record, but song by song, this one stands right up there with it to me. Since this album was produced by a variety of people, the sound of it is a lot more encompassing than 6 Feet Deep. It doesn't have that flawless dark tone, but it gives the MCs a great mix of vibes to work with. And on the top of that great production, the MCing took a huge step on this record, especially for Too Poetic. Listening to this album, it sounds like he was on a personal mission to prove that he was an elite MC. The 1-2 punch of Too Poetic and Fruquan is perfection. And then when you add the RZA to that, you got a recipe for success. This album, while still feeling true to the Gravediggers, is definitely lighter in tone and slightly more conscious. And I think that's perfect. This album, not being a retread of the original, helps make this one of the greatest two-album runs of all time.
Hey, sometimes, like with a follow-up album, sometimes it's always good to kind of change the sound a little bit so it won't sound stale. While it's cool to kind of have like some of that sound similar to the first album, like the set when you change the sound and the direction of the second album, just in general, it sometimes works out for the best. And based on how he describes it, it seemed like another album I have to add on the list to check out as well. I've thought about checking out Gravediggers as well for years, but haven't gotten around to listen to them. But I like the info that Def Goldblum's given for this group. Great little intro for those that may not have heard the group before, as only knew by or only known by their name as such. Oh shit! I got a little text message.
Too Poetic tragically died after a long fight with colon cancer in July of 2001.
Rest
during
in
his
peace.
Battle, he refused to slow down, recording the Gravediggers' third album, Nightmare in A Minor, in the process. At this point, the group featured only Poetic and Fruquan, and it's probably the group's darkest work yet, including many references to Poetic's struggle with cancer, as well as apocalyptic themes to do with the teachings of the 5% Nation. Although RZA didn't take part in this album, some Wu-Tang affiliates such as Fourth Disciple, True Master, Prodigal Son, Beretta 9, and Shogun Assassin were all involved. Fruquan went on to release a few solo projects, and even released some more music under the Gravediggers' name as recently as 2021. RZA, as we all know, became one of the most important artists in hip-hop history. Prince Paul, who had an absolutely incredible career, had a podcast with Open Mike Eagle called What Had Happened Was. And there's an episode where he does a full deep dive and talks about the Gravediggers for a full hour. So definitely check that out if you want to know more about the group. Rest in peace, Too Poetic.
Yes, indeed. Rest in peace, Too Poetic.
Thanks for watching, everybody. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. As always, if you enjoyed the video and want to leave a like and subscribe to the channel, that is always appreciated. Make sure you go follow me on Twitter and Instagram.
I knew it. That's the same guy.
I'm posting about whatever albums or songs that I'm feeling at the time. So if you want more recommendations, go check that out. Also, make sure to go check out the producers that I have links to down in the description. I've been lucky enough to have some very talented artists provide the beats for my videos lately, so thank you to all of them for that. And if you're a beat maker who wants me to use some of your beats in the future, hit me up on Twitter, I always respond. I hope you guys have been having a great 2022. As always, there's a lot more coming at you guys soon. Thanks for watching.
Short but sweet documentary. I like it.
This is Dave, head of marketing at a ketchup company, about to
that's
use
always something
to handle a tight deadline.
Shit. Pause this bullshit. I ain't trying to hear no goddamn commercials on my channel. But anyway, that was a great documentary about a very iconic group amongst the hardcore rap. Not just in the hardcore rap, but also hip-hop in general. You know what I mean? Like, So based on how I described, it seemed like they were a major deal back in their time. And plus, not to mention, me myself have listened to quite a bit of hardcore music myself. They've added this group to my list as well, people to check out. know what I mean? Since it is the month of Halloween, I might as well do so. I do plan on doing a live stream. Maybe this week, maybe like Saturday or Sunday. Maybe Sunday morning. Who knows? I might do one on Sunday morning to kind of do a lot. Maybe Sunday morning or Saturday sometime. I'm not sure exactly. It may not be, who knows? Because things may come up. But yeah, I might, let me see what the comment section is saying. And I'm going to look into the producers they name dropped. Okay, Malik. Okay, I might check out SoundCloud. I got a SoundCloud account. Okay, bet. If you want me to track to more like documentaries amongst, say, the horrorcore rap scene or just anything related to the Halloween season, like whether it's movies, TV shows, even like books or true crime stories, post them in the comment section below. If this is your first time watching this reaction video, be sure to hit that like button, hit that notification button, hit that subscribe button as well, and hit that donation link to my Cash App to help support your boy with this channel, which we post in the description box below. God damn, my phone is ringing. Got a whole bunch, three different text messages. So I'm just going to check it out real quick after I get done. So this is your boy Black G92 about to sign off. Pilot your boy. Peace.